All right, we now all know that bombs were sent out across the nation. It is a moment that has given some pause to consider just what the hell we're doing to ourselves for political gain. But the president seems to see it differently, as a time to double down on divisiveness. Last night, he refused to own any responsibility for what's been going on. Instead, he blamed the media, which had just been targeted by a bomb. The best he could do was haltingly read prepared remarks that we need more unity. This morning, he tweeted what unity seems to mean to him. Here's what it was. A very big part of the anger we see today in our society is caused by the purposely false and inaccurate reporting of the mainstream media that I refer to as fake news. It's gotten so bad and hateful that it is beyond description. Mainstream media must clean up its act fast. Then came Sarah Sanders, who came at the media as well and said it is we who need to change, not the president.
Certainly, the media has a role to play in this process. When 90% of the coverage about this president is negative, despite the historic successes, when the ideas are perpetuated and continued of negativity, that is not helpful for the American discourse.
Is it helpful for the American discourse for her to not recognize a single attribute or contribution of the president to this dynamic? How is she supposed to have credibility, let alone be helpful in this situation, if she can't even admit what is so obvious to everyone else? The president isn't helpful to American discourse. The most lies, the most insults, the ugly descriptions of others, the most we've seen in a generation of leadership. It is his defining characteristic, what he himself calls his winning edge. And then Sanders went even further.
The president, I think, could not have been more presidential yesterday when he spoke directly to the American people. He condemned this violence. Let's not get lost in who is responsible for this heinous act.
They sit on the couch and they listen and they nod, not here. Presidential? Sarah, you keep using that word. As Inigo Montoya said, you keep on using that word. I do not think it means what you think it means. First one to tweet me the movie and the scene gets a hat or a shirt or a mug. Your choice. Now, I inject some levity, of course. Why? Because we got to take a breath. Otherwise, we'll be consumed by the pathetic nature of it all. A president who sets a standard for ugly talk, who sees himself as a victim when the people he calls his enemies get bombs sent to them, and he's the victim. But why wouldn't he think that when he is surrounded by those who nod and echo his hypocrisy? Sarah Sanders there with a stunningly straight face, calling his shirking of any role or responsibility presidential. And then comes the backup, those doing the dance of twisted facts and false step narratives that I call the Fox Trot. Take this tweet from Fox Business host Lou Dobbs, suggesting this morning without evidence that it's all just fake news and fake bombs. Fake? Again, the FBI is investigating it as a domestic terror event. There's no basis for the cynical assumption. And by the way, doing that, that's fake. And then comes the Trump Trinity.
The president condemned these acts and was immediately rebuked by the Democratic Party for condemning the acts, not quite enough.
The media, the left, Democrats all trying to score cheap political points and a political victory on this.
The fingers pointing at Trump, you know, all day long on the other networks, which I found disgusting.
Look at my boy here at his show. He put up a chyron. He couldn't even name CNN. Are we really in this place? And to think, I was heartened by their reporting yesterday and their conciliatory tone. Fake civility, I guess. Let me ask my friends there. If it were you who'd been targeted by a bomber in a thinly veiled attempt to support the left, God forbid. God forbid. I'll tell you what, though, I wouldn't blame you for it. God forbid that happens. I hope you and your families are safe. A bomb is no mere harassment or threat. And again, I would be there if it were any of you, because that is wrong, and you've got to condemn the efforts, you've got to do it quickly, and you've got to do it consistently. It's not legal. It's not right, and neither is when we see media figures or political figures chased out of private establishments. It's not right. It's not legal. There's a better way to get your message across. And yet, they can turn a blind eye to the media that they claim to be a part of. When it is attacked, I just don't get it. Did you need the bomb to go off? Would that have mattered? We covered what happened to Congressman Scalise. You saw him there on the Fox show. For what it was, a national tragedy. Thank God he made it. This nation was pulling for him, and rightly so. The man who did it was delusional and a disgrace, and he needed to be called out as such, and he was. And then he wasn't given attention. We didn't do a deep dive into him any more than necessary so that no one would think that there was any gain in that. If you can't see this the same way as if it were you, and if the president can't rise above his worst traits even now, the question that all this confronts us with is, are we just doomed to politics that are an ever-accelerating race to the bottom? That's a tough question, but we got to deal with it.